So here we're going to see if this improper integral converges or not. And once again, we'll be using the comparison theorem for this. And the truth is that we cannot integrate 1 over ln x. That right there has no answer for the integral. It is non-elementary. But it's okay, because for comparison theorem, we don't have to integrate that directly anyways, right? However, we still need to come up with something that we know much better to compare this with that, right? But I cannot tell you guys to do the things that we did in the previous video. I cannot tell you guys. Let's go ahead and pick the highest power of x on the top and the highest power of x on the bottom, right? Because we don't have 1 on top and ln x on the bottom. So that strategy wouldn't work for this one. It works pretty nicely when we are dealing with rational expressions and power functions and things like that. But not for this. Anyways, here it's a good time for me to tell you guys the list. So let me write this down. I call the following the list, right? And the idea of the list is that we are going to list out all the functions that goes to infinity as x goes to infinity. So as x goes to infinity, so let me just put this down as x goes to infinity. We note logarithm functions, it's the smallest. So we put on ln x right here. And the next smallest function is the power function. And we'll just write this down as x to the p's power. And to demonstrate how small this is, all right, I'm going to put down double less than sign, just to emphasize that, all right? And the next smallest function is going to be exponential functions, some base to some x power. So we'll put this down as like this, b for the base to the x power. And perhaps the biggest functions that we may see at the moment is x to the x. Okay, so here are some conditions. Right here, p has to be greater than 0, and b has to be greater than 1. But I'm going to write that down later on. So this is what we have. There's another version for that. I will take this right here, and I'll do the reciprocal of this. So in another word, if I do the reciprocal, I will have 1 over ln x. And here we'll have 1 over x to the p. And here I will have 1 over b to the x. And here I have 1 over x to the x. As you can see, ln x was the smallest earlier. But once I take the reciprocal of this, this in fact becomes the biggest. So I will have to switch the inequality sign. So this will be the greater than that, greater than this, and then so on. Right? Okay, so now I will just tell you guys the values for the p. P has to be positive, and the value for b has to be greater than 1 in order for this to be true. All right, so what do I mean by all this? Now you see we have 1 over ln x right here, right? In fact, you can see that this is the biggest function among all this right here. And that's what we're trying to deal with. Inside, it's a pretty big function compared to the other ones. And you should also think about this right here. Whenever you have an integral, all right, an improper integral per se, right here, if inside it's big enough, you know this right here, that's the only way to get to infinity, right? Diverges if the inside is big enough. Likewise, if you have integral, if the inside is small enough, that's the only way to end up with a convergent, right? So I'll put down small in the quotation mark and big enough in the quotation mark. Here, we are dealing with a big enough function, isn't it? It seems to be a big function because the list suggests a so, isn't it? Therefore, I suspect this right here to be a divergent. Once again, I suspect this right here to be a divergent because from the list, it's telling me 1 over ln x is a pretty big function, okay? So now, in order for me to demonstrate and actually show you that this is indeed a divergent, I still have to come up with something that I know, right? And then do the inequality business and things like that. Which improper integral do we know is divergent? Well, the answer for that is, well, there are a lot of answers, but perhaps one of the simplest answers is the integral from some number to infinity, 1 over x, isn't it? That's like right here, isn't it? So let me just indicate that right here. This is what I mean by like a breaking point. So among 1 over x to the p, this is where you get a p integral, the p test, right? This right here, let me just make a cut. We know 1 over x to the first power. Anything before that, if it's bigger than 1 over 1, if this right here is bigger than 1 over x, this right here are big enough, they should diverge. Anything less than 1 over x, this right here converges, because this right here will consider be small. All right? So the deal is that because I suspect this is to be a divergent, let me use this one, right? Hopefully everything works out nicely. So here is the write-out. First of all, let me just put this down. This is what we know. We know that the integral, and I want to match with the limit of the integrations. So we have e to infinity, e to infinity. And then inside, I want to use this 1 over x dx, right? And you see this is x to the first power, so you can indicate that for me. P is equal to 1, which is less than or equal to 1. As long as p is less than or equal to 1, this is the type 1 situation for the p test, right? This right here diverges. Now we will do the check. All right? So we are using a divergent here. That means I will put down this right here and put down the improper integral that we want to do on the left hand side. I want to show that it is greater than or equal to. So the check is, I'll put this down. Integral from e to infinity, this is 1 over ln x dx. I don't know technically, but I hope to show you guys this is indeed bigger than or equal to that one. Integral from e to infinity, 1 over x dx. Okay, compare the inside. So we have 1 over ln x. Is this bigger than or equal to 1 over x to the first power? Let me write down 4. X is greater than or equal to e. And by the way, if x is greater than or equal to e, 1 over e and then bigger, right? And likewise, 1 over ln e, never negative. So I will just put this down. It's greater than or equal to 0. Let me just indicate that. Okay, so here are a few ways to do it. You can already tell, right? 1 over ln x is indeed bigger than or equal to 1 over x because by the list. However, I just created this list myself. So if you're in my class, yes, you can just quote the list. And you should seriously have to have the list in mind. That way, that'll be really helpful to come up with something that you know to compare with, all right? And this idea here as well. The integral of a big enough function will be divergent. Integral of a small enough function will be convergent. And of course, we're talking about improper integrals. And I didn't put on limit because you may have a type 1 or type 2 situations. But anyways, this is how you can do it, just to be slightly more legitimate, all right? Anyways, x greater than e, so this is always positive. Likewise, ln x will also always be positive when x is greater than or equal to e. That means I can cross, multiply, and keep the same inequality sign. X times 1 is x. Is this greater than or equal to ln x times 1, which is ln x? Well, now I have to show you, right? This is what you can do. You can show me from the graph, assuming you don't want to quote the list. From the graph, you know x is just a straight line like this, right? This is how y is equal to x look like. So let me just indicate that. And for ln x, you can use a graphing calculator to verify it, but I'll graph this for you guys right here. Ln x looks like this. And this is 1, 0, because ln 1 is 0. And it actually goes like this. They never touch each other, by the way. Right? As I said, you can just use a graphing calculator to verify it. But this is the graph of y equals to ln x. So the idea is that you can just graph x and graph ln x together and put this down to show me, because x is above ln x all the time. Therefore, this inequality is, of course, true, isn't it? right? And once again, this is true because I provide a graph to show you. Okay, so that's a good news because I have a true inequality from here. That means I can draw my conclusion right here. And the conclusion is that one also diverges, right? So let me put that down in writing. E to infinity 1 over lnx dx also diverges by the comparison theorem with the divergent integral that we know, which is by the integral from e to infinity 1 over x dx. Once again, what you know, do the check, draw the conclusion, and here is the list that you should remember. Especially keep this in mind, it's going to be really, really helpful. And that's it.